for that. Can the virus transmit through our sweat glands? I know many know now the experts are worried it could transmit through fecal matter. Also in the early days, we were even worried about the air recirculation of an air conditioning system. So Lisa, I do not know if you are new to Dr. Bean. We have been talking about the fecal matter transmission or orofecal route of transmission for a long time. And the reason for that is that orofecal transmission by coronaviruses has been discussed in the books since 2012 and 2016 and even before that. It's a known route. And the reason for that is that the orofecal route, normally what happens is if I draw a stomach here, so let's say this is a stomach, usually what happens is that the enveloped viruses, the viruses that have an envelope around them, sort of a membrane around them, when we put enveloped viruses in the acidic environment of the stomach, stomach will break down their envelope and the virus dies. However, in case of COVID-19, COVID-19 has a very thick fur on it, just like an animal has fur. It has a lots of glycoproteins on its surface, just like fur. And that thick layer, lipid layer, slippery layer of lipid jelly, its glycoproteins, that protects it, protects this virus when it is in the stomach. And that protects it from the stomach acids. Because of that, coronaviruses can cause gastritis and then cause the gastrointestinal infections as well. That means for the remaining intestinal tract, they can cause infections there as well. This is why some of the patients have, at least 5% of the patients have GIT symptoms because of coronavirus. And this is why the coronaviruses are transmitted or excreted in the fecal material as well. And it is known that coronavirus can be transmitted in the fecal material or excreted in the fecal material for up to 50 days after the symptoms have subsided. So fecal oral route is a known thing. So back here to Lisa's question. First question, sweat glands. No, there is no known mechanism that coronavirus can enter the sweat glands and then appear in the sweat. So normally what happens is, so let's say this is a sweat gland. What happens is there are, so let's say this is the skin surface and the sweat is coming out like this. The sweat cells, the glandular cells, usually make the sweat by, so these are, I'm trying to make sort of triangular cells here. So what happens is, this is a cell, and the cell will make some sweat in it, and that sweat particle or piece of sweat will come out to the surface and will be, with a tiny part of the cell sometimes, breaks down, and then the sweat is secreted out. And in the other cases, there are CFTR channels as well that release sodium separately and chloride separately, and then water is accumulated in here. Now, it is not seen so far that coronavirus can actually come into these cells, infect them, and then be able to come out through the sweat channels or break down the cells and come out in the gland and then appear in the sweat. Maybe if we artificially infect a sweat gland, then maybe it can do it, but sweat is not known to have coronaviruses in it. So no worries about the sweat. Fecal oral matter, yes. And then recirculation of an air conditioning system, yes, we knew that as well, that the aerosol can actually be recirculated through the any circulating system. Continuing on, next question. Mardik Bidet.